All right, so this is how you replace a garter spring on a 30 series torque converter driver. Now, I keep having an issue where the garter spring, or the back garter spring, and the driver keeps breaking. So, as you can see, they have two garter springs here. There's one and another one there. I just got done replacing the back spring in this one, but what's happening is that back garter spring will break, and then it'll get wedged behind the weights here, and it won't allow the driver to retract back into itself and release the belt. So it's locking the torque converter up, and the belt won't release, and, you know, of course, the wheels lock up at that point as well. So just finished that one. As you can see, I have two of them that I had to repair, and you can see that one's missing that back garter spring. So I'm going to put this one on. And the way you go about that is really simple. You just pull off the weights. They just slide right off. You go ahead and take your spring. And this is just a replacement spring. It's just, you know, same specs as the factory spring. They do sell different springs that let it engage at different RPMs, but I just went with the factory ones, but right now I'm just repairing these back to normal. But we just secure the two ends together. Just get it started here. And we're just gonna mold it around. There we go. As simple as that. So now we've got both our springs on there. And you just push it back on. And, you know, there's a little bit of resistance just to those springs flex a little bit, but we got it on and we'll just push it back down. There you go.